Hey guys, Robin here. Welcome to my channel, Oracle Rising. Thanks for tuning in today. So I wanted to talk a little bit about Halloween and the origin of Halloween and how we got to where we are today and how we celebrate it. So I hope you enjoy the video and I'm just gonna dig right in. So Halloween started as a Celtic festival and it was called Samhain, and it still is, and it's spelled S-A-M-H-I-N. So this started with people dressing up in their villages and, you know, wearing costumes. And the reason that they wore costumes was to actually ward off evil spirits. So this is probably the kind of behavior that got people burned at the stake for being witches, because the Celtic and pagan way of life was really misunderstood by other cultures. So, and that's a whole nother video, but this basically came in at the end of harvest season. It also heralds the thinning of the veil. So there's a lot of superstition and mysticism at that time of, you know, when you go back into the sort of ancient pagan roots. And if you have a really good visual of that show called Outlander and how people express their beliefs, you know, you might have a really good impression of what was actually going on in those times. I can't even imagine, but it looks really fascinating, although I really don't want to time travel back. So this is also going to be a really major turning point of the Wheel of the Year. And this couldn't come at a better time, because we've actually had a very stressful sort of an endurance race of a year here. So to describe the Wheel of the Year a little bit better, this is something that appears in tarot, and it's called the Wheel of Fortune or Fortune's Wheel, or again, the Wheel of the Year, and it indicates being able to move forward on your journey. So there's been a lot of life lessons to be learned, a lot of very difficult and traumatic things to learn in 2020 so far. So October 31st could be a real change. You know, it can really bring in a new sort of way of looking at life for you, hopefully. You know, costumes, what people do now is so far and away different than what, you know, the ancient pagan practices that were done. Now people dress up in Halloween costumes to, you know, win a best costume prize or go around trick-or-treating. When I was a kid and I lived in a really small town, we would go house to house and say Halloween apples, and, you know, it was really fun. But, you know, people kind of lose touch with what really started things off. So looking back at sort of the pagan origins of something as special as Halloween, where people can really just sort of let loose, it really meant a lot to me to be able to do this for you. So I did bring the Witch's Tarot in because I wanted to look at this specifically, the major turning point of the Wheel of the Year, and pull a card for that, because people have been really exploring themselves. You know, the part of the pandemic that is, I guess it could be either a dark cloud or a silver lining, is spending so much time getting to know themselves and the people around them. So here, let me just pull a card here, and I almost broke one in half. So we have the Six of Cups, and I really want you guys to check this out. Okay, so we have a wizard here in this particular Six of Cups. Wait a second, it's the Seven, sorry. So it's really like your options were limited down and you started to really understand what matters most in your life and being able to change the course of your life here. And there's a wizard in this card, which I absolutely love, because he's really asking you to focus on what should you carry forward into your life. You know, what are you ready to shed? What are you really ready to bring into your current reality? And I just wanted to pull another card here, and this is the King of Pentacles. So this is focusing on what really makes you feel rich, you know, in your heart. Is it the people? Is it, you know, maybe it's time for you to just move on and start a whole new life? You know, where do you want to go right now? And it's basically going to be at your fingertips, because you should have had lots of opportunity for self-exploration coming up to October 31st. And, you know, this is also going to be a really important time, you guys, to take part in cleansing rituals, similar to nature preparing for winter. So cleansing rituals, it is, once again, getting rid of, you know, any... I'm getting the word freight. Like, what is making you heavier? Like, what is really the most important thing in your life to be able to move forward? So cleansing yourself of negativity, maybe cleansing your home, giving things to Goodwill, just cleansing everything that no longer serves you as you move into a new aspect of your life, you know, and moving into winter also, and understanding that this is a really good time to get in touch with who you are. So this is also going to be a prime opportunity to welcome the new and unknown and release negativity. So there's always a silver lining to very challenging and troubling times. And I know, like, a lot of people like to talk about the pandemic, and I'm not one of those people, but, you know, a lot of people had their lives go through an incredible upheaval, myself included. I had some really devastating things happen to me and my family. But trying to stay positive through all of that. So this is going to be really important to release any negativity. I know people are just arguing about everything, you know, anti-maskers, and, you know, I've been yelled at in public a couple times, you know, just ridiculous. People are terrified. So kind of distancing yourself from that and releasing negativity. And this is where all these ancient rituals came into existence as well, because the pagans, the Celts, they did not want any negativity related to their lives. They didn't want spirits coming in that were unwanted. They wanted to also bless their harvest that was coming in. So really a huge, massive turn, you know, change in seasons, change in life, change in your atmosphere, your energy. So let me just pull a card here, and I'm looking at release negativity. And, you know, this card is just pretty much sums up, you know, 2020 to this point. We've got the Tower card, you know, things being ejected. You can see that, just the lid being blown off of things. And there's a lot of conspiracy theories going on related to the pandemic and the government. So, and there's also people that are saying that this is going to be a world reset. There's going to be a new world order. There could be things coming in such as, you know, basic income and, you know, a lot of change happening. So this is a really important time to choose which side of the fence do you want to be on. You know, are you living in fear, or do you want to see the potential of a situation? So this is going to be a really big challenge for a lot of people. You know, Halloween is about more than just candy and costumes. And I say that as I'm sitting here wearing my my costume hat, but it's a very important time of year. And if you're really into, you know, your spiritual life and an ascension path, you might be exploring your roots and where you came from and how your ancestors looked at different parts of the seasons changing and why they were so sensitive to the thinning of the veil, which is where, you know, you can contact spirits and your spirit guides a little bit more clearly. So I'm going to pull another card here for you guys. And we do have this Strength card. So a lot of people, you really would have found out what you're made of, you know, and how strong you are. And, like, again, what really matters in your life. So, you know, I think it's really important to look at not just what you're told about major holidays and events going on, but dig a little bit deeper, you know, look beneath what is being advertised, what is being, you know, there's a certain amount of brainwashing going on here. You could really be hitting a new potential for yourself, especially with the October 31st, you know, massive holiday going on. So look a little bit deeper at your roots, you guys, and you'd be probably a little bit surprised at how your ancestors saw October 31st. And keep in mind also that this is a full moon on October, I'm speechless all of a sudden, on October 31st. So a lot of energy happening for you guys. This could really be a jumping off point instead of just everything being blown apart, which is what it looks like on the surface. But underneath it all, this has been a real test of faith for people, and to maybe get in closer contact with your families and exploring your roots, like I said before. So really interesting and fascinating event coming up for you guys. And I just saw an angel number, which is 1010. So you may wish to check that out after I wrap up the video, which is going to be right away. And I'm just being guided to do a deck cut and do one more card here for you guys. And you know what's really interesting is I just pulled this Lover's card, and I'm going to show it to you right away. This could be a really good time for you to communicate with people that you really love that have, you know, departed the earth. They're no longer in human form. You could also be clearing the way to meet somebody that is your divine partner, your twin flame, that is going to be blessed by the heavens above, by the angels. There's a lot of love here coming from spirit. You could be just really stepping into a new portion of your life where, you know, all the love and support from your team and spirit is going to be a whole lot more visible. You'll be able to get immediate responses from your angels. And again, a really important love coming into your life. And this could be in the form of a friend or a romantic partner. So this is going to be a really interesting Halloween. So I hope you guys enjoy yourselves. And yeah, I'm going to wrap up the video. So I'll see you guys back here another time. But take care and have fun. Okay, bye for now. Bye.